Hey guys, DMic here, hello and welcome back to another episode of Super Nintendo Sundays with some Bubsy. Long time no see, hopefully you're all doing okay. We're back here in the Spaghetti West, and we are going to be grabbing some balls today. So I did want to come clean, viewers, I lied. I lied to all of your faces. I lied to all of your computer screens. You can, in fact, gather lives. And if you like gathering lives, then you should like this video, you should comment, and you should subscribe to show your support for the truth. 500 yarn balls acquired will net you a life. I said before that I didn't think that was possible. It is, and that's how you do it. So make sure you're grabbing all your yarn boxes, grabbing and playing with your balls. 500 will get you the fabled life, and you'll need it because this game is a jerk. So we've got some long horses to deal with today. We're going to be grabbing checkpoints, we're going to be grabbing our balls, and we're going to be getting some lives. Alongside these weird, spiky Jabba the Hutt looking things. Not entirely sure what any of this is supposed to be or mean. Story of my life. But we're going to take our time. One of the things that this game does really well is force the user to make a lot of mistakes, myself included. I'm pretty much the target audience for making a ton of mistakes. Yeah, but this game is brutal, and you know, as much as I like sort of enjoy the challenge of the platforming, some of this just feels a little bit unfair. Are these spikes? Okay, those are spikes. Well, it worked for Clint. I thought it was just an entryway. It wasn't. So anyway, make sure you get your checkpoints. Make sure you take your time. Don't land on those spiky things. Basically, like real life and Australia, everything is trying to kill you. So we're gonna pace ourselves. I know that this is a platform where you want to go and you want to go fast and you want to run, which you should be able to, but I'm not a speedrunner by any stretch of the imagination. I have no chance to have an inclination on what's coming. Story of my life. So instead, I'm just gonna take it easy. We're gonna go slow. Slow and steady wins the race. I know for a fact that there is... Okay, I missed it. Cool. There's a life there. I could have gotten it if I would have known. I did know, and I still messed it up. I don't know why I said that. That's okay. We're doing fine. These levels are pretty brutal, though. This game has stopped pulling the punches as we run into the wall. Just make sure that you're trying to get close to that 500 mark between now. Grab as many of the yarns as you can. You'll have until the end of the next level to have your final total. So just make sure you do that. After that, it resets in level 2 of this world. I don't know why, but that's the cap. So if you can at least get most of the way to 500 in this first level like I have, then you're in good shape. This level's a doozy. There's a tumbleweed here, I know that one. My D-pad is not working very well, which is great, because I only need to be able to control where I'm going. This is when I start to kind of lose track of where things are. I don't have the muscle memory or knowledge of where the explorey stuff is supposed to be. So I'm just trying my best. I'm really struggling with trying to control this right now. Okay. What was the point of that? There is a yarn box up here though, but there's also the government, so. Do we pass on it, viewers? What do you think? I'm gonna let it go the other way. Will you turn around? Yeah, boy. Let's do a sneak attack. Here we go. No harm, no foul. What a pigeon. There's a lot of hidden kind of corners and spots you can explore to gather more collateral. I'm just so nervous because everything here is clearly trying to kill me. Which is not too far removed from real life. But all you gotta do is... Alright, I think that there's... This is where things get a little hinky. No! That was a controller error. I'll blame that. I think that there is a life around here somewhere. I don't know where it is, but I might have passed it. That's okay. Whew. All right. So as you can see, we're being accosted by meatballs. I'm assuming this is supposed to be... Ooh, I thought that was... I thought that counted. I thought I touched the hitbox. This is supposed to obviously be the play on the Spaghetti Western. Which I don't even remember where that came from. The terminology is lost on me, but I am... Whoa! Whoa, I was gliding for a hot minute there. No! It's the brutal part of this game is... No matter what you do, there's always something around the corner that's probably going to take you out. Even if you know what's coming. Yeah, these things are so weird. What are you? Basically the question I get asked on a first date. So here we go. Oh, I was so close to the checkpoint, I just jumped over it. That's unfortunate. Okay, so we're going to kill the prairie dogs. I want to say there's a good amount. Oh, yeah, here we go. Got more yarn boxes. I think there's another bird back there, so if we can avoid it, we'll just sneak in and grab your balls and get out of here. How's that sound, Your Honor? All right, here we go. It's really hard not to make those jokes, so honestly, if those offend you, blame the Let's Play. Don't blame me. Oh, boy. What did the weird bubbles do? Does anybody know? Is anybody confirmed? All right, where is the... Oh, I don't like this at all. Where's the ledge? There we go. Okay, can I get up here? Yes. All right, we need 8 more. Don't forget, of course, you can press up and down to do nothing. No, you can press up and down to check your surroundings. So make sure you do that. I think there's another life just right around the corner. Whoa! Not today. Bird brain. Got him. Okay. I imagine there's probably another one over here. Yeah, this is kind of what makes this game a little bit unfun. It's just how careful you have to be at all times. I don't like this. Oh, wait. Oh, no. I don't want to get to that yet. Hold on, we'll come back. I have 4 minutes to hit the ending. One. Ooh. I need 6 more yarn balls. Is this a thing? Like, what's over here? Okay, I should have just taken the ending. That would have been fine. Oh, back-to-back deaths. I would have been fine with not doing that. I do have a continue, though, by the way, so... It's not the end of the world. Alright, we'll learn from our mistakes. I think all the enemies should be... despawned. If I can get 6 yarn balls from this ending, I'll be fine with it. Okay, we did. Nice. I'm not sure what determines the amount that pop out from the coin Bubsy face, but... We're doing okay. I mean, we're on to level 3, chapter 8, A Fistful of Yarn. And we're gonna do just this one last level here to end today's foray into the West. I don't know where I'm going. Oh, there's a stack of them. That is a pyramid scheme. There are quite a bit of yarn balls up here, though, so I will grab them. I don't think I'm getting to 500 again. This is probably one of those things where it's like, you can get to the 500 pretty easily every 2 levels. Maybe every 1 level if you're, like, super advantageous and ambitious in knowing where things are. That's what I would imagine being a big culprit in you finding things. If you're good at sniffing it out. Yours, you good at sniffing it out? That, okay. I don't agree with that. Although, this is chapter 8, and chapter 8 was... Did both levels count as chapter 8? I don't know. I'm only going to be doing this one and... Or the previous two levels and then this one, unless... The last Into the Canyon level doesn't count as one. It counts in my heart, and that's all that matters. Since I'm the one who is recording all of this. Okay. Oh, there we go. Nice. Ooh. Oh, there's... Wow, game. I'm shocked by that, honestly. Two lives back to back. The generosity is unfounded. You're like a rich capitalist. Donating a $1,000 check to an orphanage. That always makes me laugh. And like, okay, let's be real here. People don't have to give their money out. There's nothing saying that you have to donate your money. But I do find it a little funny whenever you've got somebody that clearly has like just disproportionate disposable income. And they're like... Like, there's, like, a hurricane or, like, some sort of, like, a natural disaster, and they're like, I'm helping! And they give, like a $500 check to the Giraffe Society of America. No, in real talk, though, like, I don't know. Kind of just makes me a little sad, but whatever. Oop! Got the bonus. Ooh, there's not a lot. Are these... What am I seeing? I can't tell if this is supposed to be, like, an invincibility thing, because there is also the other invincibility thing. So I'm not 100% sure. Can I sneak into this? There we go. I feel pretty good about this. I do have a continue in my back pocket, which I believe the continue is 9 lives? 10 lives? Ooh. I got the... I got the gophers hanging out in the smokestacks. Get out of here. Alright. This wasn't terrible. I mean, you don't know how many tries this took me to get, but you know, whatever. What you're seeing is what you're seeing. Alright, so that's 3 levels down. Oh, there's another end of the canyon. Each of these have one. Maybe I'll do one more, just because I hate myself. Alright, where's the tumbleweed boy? Ugh, I did hit jump. I pressed the B button. I had my finger on it. No controller came, unfortunately. Okay. Well, that's just stupid. Alright. I do realize this video is incredibly short, so I will do one more. Alright, where's the... There we go. Hitting the B button. It is working now. Oh. I love that that's basically like... How this game is operating for me is just relying on reaction. It is good though, you know, it's showing me that in the event of somebody almost slamming into my car, I would have the reaction time to get out of the way. Although I did say that just now, and I have hit deer before, or in fairness, they've hit me. I will never admit to hitting deer. I hit one once. Coming back from getting dinner. Oh, that's not fair. I was coming back from getting dinner, and a deer did jump into my car. Not into my car, but in space to my car. I did not have a deer passenger for a moment, but it jumped into my car, which was pretty uncool. And it broke off my side view mirror, which, you know, who needs those? Who needs to be able to see? For those of you who drive a... Oh, there's sharks. F this shark. All right. For those of you who drive a modern vehicle... Ooh, I did not think that was going to count. Most modern vehicles have mirrors that are controlled pretty exclusively by electronics. And so because of that, you will find... What is this? Ooh, is that a... I don't know if that was a life or not. You'll find that it is very expensive to have... companies that repair your vehicle do so to fix your mirror. I think that by needing to get that mirror... Ooh, I'm dead. By needing to get that mirror fixed, it took, I want to say, a month for them to fix... Or to get the parts in to fix it. It didn't take them a month to fix it, thankfully. So I had to wait a month for them to get the parts. And then because I have insurance, which you're required to in the US and A, I had insurance. And they took care of the payment side of things. Ooh. Ooh. Where am I going? This better be worth it. What is this? Some sort of like... I'm assuming that's some sort of like... referring to the natives? I don't know. Whoa! And we're dead. I don't care for that. But I did get it fixed eventually. And the funny thing was that when I did get my car back, I did find deer hair wedged in my door handle where I had hit it. And I don't know what happened to that. I'm dead again. I don't know what happened to that deer after that. Hopefully it went along its, you know, merry deer life. But it probably died. I don't know. I'd feel bad if I killed it on accident. It was not my intention. I'm not a moiterer. Alright. Oh, this is stressful. Whoa. Oh, that's... that's not chill. Have I not ever gotten that one? I guess not. I don't... is there... how do you get lower? Is there a lower place to go? No. It's a lie? Just some jerk dropping eggs. Oh, wait, is this how you get in here? The Cave of Wonders? How do I go lower? Oh, there we go. Is there a... oh, there's a life, though. I want that. Nice. Okay, okay, we're hanging in there. I'm not a huge fan of this, though. These whole shenanigans. I wouldn't mind taking the teleporter, but... do you have to go down to go up? Is that what you're trying to tell me? Yeah, this just feels kind of stupid. Where's the... how do I... viewers. Help. I guess I'm not upset about that. I got a life out of it. And a pretty decent amount of yarn balls, so... as long as I stay to this side. Get two more and kill that guy. Sweet. Okay. This just feels like the antithesis to what you're supposed to be doing in this game. Just like slowly... plodding along, like this feels wrong. Whoa. They want you to go off fast. And maybe I'm wrong, I don't know. Maybe I'm reading into this incorrectly. Maybe the actual intent of this game was to, you know, give you the... oh, I don't like that. Are you ultimately cheese throwing? Okay. You have an infinite amount of cheese. Maybe it's to give you the false impression that you can go fast, but this game actually is supposed to be... oh, is this a boss? This might be a boss. Oh no, it's just the end. Hmm. Okay. No bonus balls, I guess. So much for that. Did not get 500, so there's... it's an unfortunate reality of that, but hey! We finished three levels with, 2 lives. So, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, everybody. I've been DMic. This has been... Super Nintendo Sundays with some Bubsy, and I'll catch you next time for more. Have a good one. Happy holidays. Even though there'll be another one of these before then. But anyway, happy holidays if you're celebrating the ones that are happening now. I'll see you next time. Bye.